Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to the Electrical Power Transmission course. Today I am going to discuss the end condenser method for medium transmission lines. In the previous lectures, we have discussed that in short transmission line calculations, effect of the line capacitance are neglected because such lines have smaller length and transmit power at relatively low voltages. However, as the length and voltage of the line increases, the capacitance gradually becomes of greater importance. Since medium transmission lines have sufficient length of almost 50 to 150 km and usually operate at voltage greater than 20 kV, therefore the effects of capacitance cannot be neglected. In order to obtain the reasonable accuracy in the medium transmission line calculation, the line capacitance must be taken into consideration. The capacitance is uniformly distributed over the entire length of the line. However, in order to make the calculation simple, the line capacitance is assumed to be lumped or concentrated in the form of capacitors shunted across the line at one or more points. The most commonly used method for the solution of medium transmission line are as below. Number 1, end condenser method. Number 2, nominal T method. Number 3, nominal pi method. Although the above methods are used for obtaining the performance calculation of medium lines, they can also be used for short lines if their line capacitance is given in a particular problem. Now I am going to discuss about the end condenser method. In this method, the capacitance of the line is lumped or concentrated at the receiving or load end as shown in the figure. This method of localizing the line capacitance at the load end overestimates the effect of capacitance due to the reason that capacitance is lumped at the end of the transmission line. In figure, one phase of the three-phase transmission line is shown as it is more convenient to work in phase instead of line-to-line values. Let IR is the load current per phase, R is the resistance per phase, XL is the inductive reactance per phase, C is the capacitance per phase, cos phi R is the receiving end power factor, VS is the sending end voltage. Now the phasor diagram for the circuit is shown in the figure. Note the construction of phasor diagram. The load current IR lags behind VR by phi R. The capacitive current IC leads VR by 90 degree as shown in the figure. The phasor sum of IC and IR is the sending end current IS. The drop in the line resistance is ISR, AB in phase with IS. Whereas inductive drop ISXL BC leads IS by 90 degree. Therefore, OC represents the sending end voltage VS. The angle phi S between the sending end voltage VS and sending end current IS determines the sending end power factor cos phi S. Taking the receiving end voltage VR as the reference phasor, we have load current can be given as below. Capacitive current is given by the following expression. The sending end current IS is the phasor sum of load current IR and capacitive current IC and is given by the following expression. By simplifying the above expression, we get the following expression. Now voltage drop per phase ISZ is given as below. Similarly, sending end voltage is given by the following expression. Thus, the magnitude of sending end voltage VS can be calculated from the above expression. Now, the percentage voltage regulation for this method is given by the following expression. Whereas, the percentage transmission efficiency for this method is equal to output power upon input power into 100. By putting the values of output power and input power, we get the following expression. Now, I am going to discuss the limitation of this method. Although end condenser method for the solution of medium line is simple to work out calculation, yet it has the drawback that there is a considerable error of about 10% in calculation because the distributed capacitance has been assumed to be lumped or concentrated. Friends, in this lecture, I have discussed about the end condenser method for the performance calculation of medium transmission line. Furthermore, in this lecture, we have derived the necessary expression for the sending end voltage, current, voltage regulation, and efficiency of the medium transmission line. That's all for today's lecture. I hope you really enjoyed this lecture. Friends, I upload many videos based on various topics of power system and motivation on regular basis. Therefore, don't forget to subscribe my channel in order not to miss my latest videos. And don't forget to share my videos with your friends and class fellows so that they can also get benefit from these videos. Thank you very much.